Nirupama, you come, Nirupama.
Yes, sir.
Test case 3. Test case 3. It is also a generic test case, common test case in not every application, maximum applications. Verify login functionality in a web application. Verify admin login in GCR Shop admin interface. Just a minute. Admin interface login page. Login page. Steps. Already I told Nepoma, in real time, you no need to write this feature file. Means you no need to write steps, etc. Generally, we select manual test cases. Test cases or test steps in any form, manual test cases. Then we automate. Okay. There you can get steps. Means navigation. Now in our training program, I'm explaining this one. You don't need to write. First launch our application. Admin interface. Just a minute. Observe the navigation. Then you have to guide me.
Okay, sir.
Project/admin. See, every web application is having minimum two interfaces. One is admin interface for maintaining the application. Second one is user interface. User interface for performing specified business operations that we will discuss in project module. Admin.
Okay.
Launch this login page directly. Okay. Next, enter valid username. Next, enter valid password. Next, click login button. Then you are getting the login page. Here, identify the verification point. Say, by capturing this current URL, this is index page before login page. By capturing and comparing this, URL and compare with expected, you need to get this type of expected result from developers. Developers only know the application design details. Otherwise, right side, top log off link is there. After successful login only, you can get log off link. Otherwise, it will show error message. Okay.
Okay, sir.
First try with this one. URL.
Okay.
Then I will show a log off link also. Here checking the element existence na. Definitely
yes,
it requires error handling. Exception handling code for negative scenario. I will show.
Okay.
First launch this web application. Okay. Jyoti.
Hello.
Yes, Jyoti.
Okay. Can you problem? Hear me now? Okay.
Problem solved?
Not really.
Okay.
This one is using, I'm using all the one.
Can you view my desktop?
Yeah, I can view now. Thank you.
Okay. No. Tangina not responding. Khan not available. Okay, continue Nirupama.
Yes, sir.
Next.
After we navigate.
Just a minute. First, I'm writing steps. First step, launch browser by creating the Chrome browser or any other browser. Browser object, we can launch browser.
Navigate or load.
Navigate or launch or load
the login page.
Login page of admin interface. Interface of the application. Application. What is that one? Just a minute. Login.php. Login. This is the URL. Next.
After that, enter a valid username and password.
Password, another step.
Okay.
Enter valid username. Enter valid username.
Enter valid password.
Next. Enter valid password.
Click on login button.
Good. Next. Click on login button.
Then
login button. See.
Capture.
This is third element in this navigation. Username one element. Next. Password one element. Next.
Button.
Login button is one element. Okay.
Then capture the URL, current URL after the login. Yeah.
See. Capture the current URL. Current URL. That is one step. That is one step.
Yeah.
Okay. Next. I think comparison is verification point.
Yes, sir. Okay. Close the browser.
Close the browser window. Close the browser window. Close the browser window. Next.
Verification.
Verification point. Next. Compare the
URL.
Captured URL with expected. With expected. Okay. Where we need to get this type of expected, Suman? How to derive this expected? Generally, we derive expected result from our requirements, but this is different scenario. Tell me, Suman.
So different browser, a different browser compared to capture.
Your answer is invalid. Invalid format also. Okay. Where we get this one, Sriniram? I think yesterday last
yes, sir,
topic.
It is from the record document or from the developers. Two ways you can get it.
Say by navigating this application or by exploring this application, I am getting this one, but it is not the proper way. Suppose while navigating this application, if any defect is there, you can't get correct URL, na?
Yes.
So it is not the proper way. Then how we get this type of expected URL? From developers. Observe Jyoti. From developers. Actually, we derive our test result, means expected, not test result. Expected result from our requirements. Requirements in any form. If it is a requirement document or user stories, or use cases, etc. But this functionality, this expected result related with application design details. So we need to get this type of expected result from development team. Otherwise, one possibility also we discussed, Sreeniram. Suppose if you have design documents and prototype screens in your test environment, sometimes we may get prototype screens from developers before test design. Getting the point?
Yes, sir.
That time, in that prototype screens, you may get this type of URLs information as well as elements information, error messages information, help messages information, etc. Any query, Nirupama?
No, sir, I'm clear.
Compare the captured URL with expected. What is the problem, Suman?
No, sir, I didn't get to, so that's why I come. I give the wrong answer.
Okay, cool, no problem. Next, input or test data. Here observe, Nirupama, try to familiar with the terminology. Input test data, both are synonyms in this scenario. But in general scenario, these two are not synonyms, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Input means input data. Test data means data for test case execution. But here, input means we use input for our test execution. That's why we are calling input as test data. But in general scenario, input is not test data, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Input is just for input data. Input not only for testing. Suppose in your real life also, suppose you are filling any form, feedback form or compliant form in your web application, then you enter some input now.
Yes, sir.
That is not test data.
Yes.
Okay. Input. Yes, in this input and test data, which one is global term and which one is local term?
Input is global term.
Yes,
and test
input
data
is global term. Test data is
local term.
Local to our testing. Okay. Yes. Next, input data. Identify the test data for this application.
Username, password.
Username. Next, password. Now observe Sreeniram. Actually, we need to collect this type of test data also from developers, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Actually, no registration facility in this application. No admin registration facility in this application. Getting?
Getting, sir.
Suppose observe another here. User login functionality is there. User login. For this user login details, you no need to collect data from anybody. Here, registration functionality is there. You can register with the details. See here, email address is there. Password, confirm password is there. With the details, you can register now.
Yes, correct.
Here, observe one general point. Suman, general point. Tested data. In some requirements, you can find collect test data. Say instead of preparing test data also correct term, but collect test data is exact term. Instead of preparing test data, writing test data, we use collect test data. Why? test data can be collected using different sources, Suman.
Yes,
suppose
sir.
Some test data tester can prepare. Example, in our application, one web form is there. In that web form, phone number object is there. As per requirements, it has to take 10 digit numeric values. For that, you can prepare data, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Suppose city name is there. It takes, suppose, 1 to 30 characters length text, means string. For that, you can prepare test data. Next, another field. Suppose some city's information is there. That city information depends on the customer business. Customer business available in 4 cities. Suppose Bangalore, Chennai, Hyderabad, Mumbai. We need to check one functionality with those 4 cities. You need to get that type of details from the customer, Srinira, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Next, suppose admin login details, error messages, help messages, you may get from developers. If you have prototype screens, okay. Otherwise, you need to collect that type of data from, suppose one test case observed. In this home page, 22 elements will be available. Getting the point?
Yes, sir.
In this home page, 22 elements will be present. You need to check that one. Who gives that information, 22 elements available in home page?
Probably the document or developers. Yes.
Developers. In requirements document, you can't get that one. Okay. See, some test data testers prepare. Some test data we need to collect from customers. Some test data from developers, etc. That's why collecting test data. Next. Expected result. Expected result, Nirupama.
Yes, sir. The index.php.
Index.php.
URL, yeah.
Index.php. This is expected URL or expected result. Next. Tanjana, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Tell me, Tanjana. Yes, actual result for this one.
So, yes, sir.
Result?
Expected result and actual result should be same.
Same. Okay. See. After test case execution. Isn't it?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Say in our test case fields, in our test case, we can't fill all fields before test execution. We fill maximum fields before execution. Next, actual result and test result fields after execution. Next, test result. Don't confuse Jyoti. Expected result, actual result, test result. Here, three results.
Yeah.
Test results means status. After comparing expected with actual, then you can get test result.
Test result.
Pass or fail. This one also after
execution.
Execution.
Yes.
Next one. Test case execution. Just a minute. Test case. Next one, field. Sriniram. This is optional field. Comments. See, this one also, after execution, before execution also, you can write some comments, but that's not required, I think. After execution, if you face any problems or if you find any new issues, then you can write meaningful comments. But comments is optional field. Getting?
Getting, sir. Okay.
Next, Selenium. WebDriver. Test case. Selenium, WebDriver, test case. From scratch, Nirupama. In framework chapter, we will discuss. Instantiating browser, browser driver file. Next, creating browser driver object that are common for every test case. For yes, that, sir. We can use common mechanism that we will discuss later.
Okay. System dot set property.
Next key.
Webdriver dot Chrome dot driver.
It is WebDriver command.
Yeah, and the value will be the path of
case sensitive, yeah. Comma value. Path of the driver executable file. It is not case sensitive. Just a minute. Get this path. Tangina, where is Khan?
He is outside. Yeah, he will come like, yeah, in 10 minutes.
Okay.
Semicolon.
Oh.
WebDriver.
Create Chrome driver object in WebDriver interface.
WebDriver,
D capital.
Mm-hmm. Driver.
Driver.
Equals new Chrome driver.
Good. New.
Chrome driver.
Chrome driver. Open and close
parenthesis.
Semicolon. We already, I think in the last
imported, case,
we already imported. That's why it is not showing. Next, maximize browser window.
Driver dot manage window dot maximize.
Observe, Suman, driver is object. Okay, browser.
Yes, sir.
Driver is object, manage is method, window is
option,
maximize is
option,
sub option. Suppose one more option is there, then you can call sub option. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Next,
load. Now we need to. Driver dot get. URL.
URL. Oh.
Yeah. No, we need to copy. Yeah.
We have that URL now. This one.
Login.
Login. Mm-hmm. Next,
we need to pass
in this navigation. We have three elements. We need to handle three elements. One is username, another is password, another is login button.
Click on login.
First, we inspected, I think. Inspect tag name input that is not reliable.
Name
type is there. User. Type is not element locator. That is one of the attribute, but not element locator. Name is there. ID not available. If ID is there, give first priority to ID. It is quicker in execution.
Yes, sir.
Name is there. Try with the name. Suppose if it is executing properly, then continue with that name. Otherwise, you can go for another locator like XPath, etc. And I already told Sriniram, XPath is 99.9%. 99% XPath will work. But only drawback of XPath is it is slower in execution. Getting?
Yes.
Next, take mouse pointer, left side. Take mouse pointer, show password. For password also name available, name password. Next, take mouse pointer, show login button. For this login button,
ID.
Tag name button, ID available, ID is
TDB1.
Okay, remember. Write those three steps.
Driver dot.
Driver find dot element. Find element. Find next.
By
dot.
Name.
Name.
Username.
Name locator value. Username. This username, dot. This name locator value also case sensitive, Jyoti. Case sensitive.
Send dot okay. Send keys.
Dot
send,
send keys. Keys. Next value is string. Next.
Driver dot find element.
Driver dot find element. Next.
By
dot name.
Password.
Name locator value. Password small letters. You can inspect.
Dot send keys.
Send keys. Why it is not showing? Send keys. Temp at 201. Not one. 2020.
Okay. I have written 2018 there, sir.
Okay.
In the notepad. Yeah. Then okay. Driver dot.
Yes, that is not correct. 2020. Next, click login button.
Yeah,
driver dot find element.
By dot ID.
By dot ID. ID locator value TDB1.
Dot click.
Dot click. Next, give some slip time. In order to load the next page, it has to, after clicking the login button, it has to load the next page. Give 3 seconds slip time. I think it is not required. How can you get that synchronization time? How can you get the synchronization problem, Suman? Safe side I'm using, but how can you get whether synchronization is required or not? By conducting dry run. Okay.
Okay.
But in this scenario,
yes,
it is not required, I think. Safe side I'm using 2000 milliseconds means 2 seconds. Next, just wait, Nirupama. Capture the current URL, Jyoti. Capture the current URL in this, at this point of time. Jyoti.
Yeah.
Capture the current URL. Tell me the step, web driver step.
Driver dot.
Driver dot.
Find element.
No. Suman, tell me the step, capture the current dot. URL.
Driver dot.
Just a minute. First, observe. Capture. Capturing means it has to return some data. It returns some data. You need to store that data into a variable. URL is string type data. It is not Boolean or some other string type data. So you need to create string variable now.
Yes, sir.
Create string variable first. String. Any meaningful variable name, suppose URL equals to continuous man.
URL dot get current URL
method. Okay, continue Nirupama.
Driver dot.
Driver dot.
Get current URL.
Get current URL. no argument, just a plain method. Next, insert verification point. If continue nirpama. If URL is string, you can apply string methods, built-in methods. Already we discussed the string built-in methods. URL dot equal. Observe Sriram. Equal support. Exact match.
Okay.
Suppose your browser is returning some extra information in real time, means navigation. That time you can go for contains means match case. That is also okay. But equals is exact match. Perfect, na?
So we should give that index.php URL there.
Index.php.
Then open.
Next.
System.println.
System.out.println. Suppose admin login. Login is
successful.
Next, status of the result.
Passed.
Close if block, open else block. Next.
System.out.println.
Suppose admin login is unsuccessful.
Okay.
Unsuccessful. It is message. Next, status of the result.
Failed.
You can write any meaningful message. Next, at the end,
driver.close.
Observe Farjana. I already told us, I think yesterday.
Yes, sir.
In real time, we don't use decision-making statements or conditional statements for inserting verification points.
Yes, sir.
We use testing framework assert commands.
Okay, sir.
Why? Selenium WebDriver doesn't have built-in result report facility. Here we are, you are defining some result using this conditional statement. But if you use TestNG or some JUnit framework for result reporting, that testing framework can't understand this user logic now.
Yes, sir.
So you need to use TestNG framework assert commands for inserting verification points in real time. Getting the points, Sriniram? Any problem?
No, sir.
But in these Selenium test cases chapters, I'm explaining with this one. In TestNG framework chapters, I will replace this
verification
point with assert commands. Then
using the framework,
you will have familiarity with both.
Getting, sir.
Can we just put one step at 22 line number system.out.put? Like capturing the URL.
That is only for dry run, na?
Oh, okay.
That is not mandatory.
Okay.
That is not mandatory. That is for dry run. Whether it is capturing or not. Suppose if you want to check whether it is capturing or not. For that, you can use system.out.println of URL. But
okay,
if you have confidence, you can directly execute. Getting the point?
Yes, sir.
Run. Maximize the browser window. Oh, why it is showing? Unsuccessful. No problem. Oh, sensitive.
Okay.
Run. Nobody observed that one. Okay. Maximize the browser window. Oh.
Change login successful.
Technical problem happened, Jyoti. You observe that
okay.
one. Technical yes, problem. Say sometimes problems in not only test scripts, Senira. Suppose that application is not responding, server issue.
Maybe.
That
server
time also you can't get correct output, na?
Yes, sir, correct.
Just a minute. Run this one once again. This time, okay. Okay, na?
Yes.
Sometimes you may get network issues.
Okay.
You need to figure out. Observe Jyoti, raise query, Jyoti.
Yeah. Hey, I'm good. Thank you.
Welcome. Observe Suman. This is positive testing, Suman. Why I am calling?
Yes, sir.
Why I am calling that this is positive testing? We are using valid input for. We are using valid
Usually,
input
man.
That. Our test case should pass. Getting?
Yes, sir.
Next, try with the negative path. For negative testing, Sriniram, we use invalid input.
Invalid
input. Yesterday I told, suppose if there is no if there is no input field in our testing, in our test case, that time you can go for incorrect expected. Getting?
Okay.
Earlier, yesterday we checked that Gmail link existence now.
Right.
At that time, no input field. Here we have input fields. So try to use incorrect
username
and password. Or if
anyone is incorrect,
then
it should fail.
It will fail only. This time it has to show valid status. Run. Valid. But application closed. Proper launching of the application. Perform your test operations and close the application. Test independency. Now observe Jyoti. Test case valid now.
Yeah.
Next. Use positive, use valid input. Valid input. Oh. Valid input. This time it should pass. Close the browser window. Admin login successful, Suman. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Next, Farjana, you come.
Yes, sir.
Same test case. I'm going to use another checkpoint, another possibility. See, check the existence of login. I think this is perfect validation. Log out link after
login.
After click on after login, successful login. After successful login. Otherwise, after login. What is that link? Run.
Log out, sir.
Just a minute. Log out, any case sensitive. log of, not log out, log of, L capital, log of single word. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Log of. Use that verification instead of this one. Instead of this one.
We're going to say that if, sir?
Tell me.
Okay. Okay, click on. Okay. So then, sir, we are just going to verify.
Yesterday we did that one, verifying the element existence.
Mm-hmm. Yes, sir. So we are just going to say that, wave elements.
Web element not required.
Okay, sir. Then we're going to go directly and set driver.get. Find elements.
Okay. Srinira.
Sir.
Tell me the step.
Yeah, you have to use the is displayed method, sir. Boolean.
Boolean.
Variable name.
Suppose link.
Is equal to.
Exists. Any meaningful variable name. Right. Link exists.
Is equal to driver dot.
Equals to
driver dot find element.
You no need to inspect that element, that is link element. Right. You try to use link text. If it is working, then fine. Otherwise, you can go for another
link text.
Most link of text. The time, link text will work.
Log off.
Case sensitive.
Dot is displayed.
Is displayed semicolon. Next, insert verification point.
If
link exists
is equal to true.
Single equals to or double equals to?
Double equals to.
Observe. In 22nd line, we use single equals to. It is assignment operator. We are assigning right side value to left side. But here double equals to, it is
comparison operator.
We are comparing things, not assigning.
Yes. Log of
true. Open.
Then statement. SOSO statement.
SOSO control space enter.
Test cases.
What is that one? Admin login is any meaningful message.
Successful and test case is passed.
Admin login is successful. Next, status of the result is
passed.
Close if block, open else block. This time unsuccessful, fail. Fired. Next at end,
driver.close. Kill dot get.
Unsuccessful.
Good. Unsuccessful. Run the test case. Two seconds wait time is there. What is taking? Okay.
Password
now.
You didn't give it. Yes.
Any problem?
No, sir. I thought you didn't give the thread dot slip. You given, right? Okay.
Okay. Next, observe. Suppose incorrect input. Invalid input for negative testing. It has to show failed status.
Yes. Admin login is unsuccessful.
It has to show failed status. Failed. As to what will happen, observe. Exception. Runtime error, na?
Yes.
Fail. Instead of showing failed status, it is showing runtime error. Already I told, whenever you check existence of any element, if it is possible scenario, then okay. If it is failed scenario, instead of showing that failed status, it will show runtime error. First to block that runtime error, then you can get your output.
Okay.
Oh, open the console. Exception name, no such element exception. How we get this exception problem? By conducting dry run only now.
Yes, sir. Right.
Next observe sample.java 22. 22nd line of this file. 22nd line of this file. Here.
Due to insert try.
Try catch try block. Try catch block. Try open.
Open curly bracket.
Close curly brackets after condition. If condition.
Okay.
Next.
No catch. Catch block.
Instead of else part. Catch. Catch.
Catch.
Null point. Exception name.
No such.
Single word. Case sensitive. No such element exception. Next. User declared name. For example, E1. Oh, I think we already imported this one. Otherwise, you need to import this one. Import statement is there, na?
No such element exception. No, yes, already given.
Exception from Selenium. Okay, this is the message. Driver dot close. What is the input? Invalid input. Run it. Observe. Admin login answer. One thing, Suman. Earlier, that browser window not closed.
Yes, sir.
Execution stopped, interrupted. This time browser window closed now.
Yes, sir.
Means we blocked that runtime error. Then it continued the execution.
Next statement. Yes.
Next statement. Admin login is unsuccessful, failed. Suppose valid input. Observe Parjana. Even though we insert exception handling code, it won't be fired for passed scenario. It only fires for failed scenario.
Yes, sir.
Run the program. This time it will show passed status, I think. Observe Jyoti. Rise query, Jyoti.
Yeah, I'm trying to understand. Thank you.